practice of culling started because of the research of men like Alan Savory. 50 years ago, Alan's recommendations helped lead the first mass cull of 40,000 elephants in Zimbabwe. Since then, Alan has dedicated his life to a controversial new theory that could not only make culling unnecessary, it could revolutionize the way in which we live on the plains.
You're traveling with your bodyguard.
I love them more than any animal.
Elephants?
Oh, yeah.
Why do you love them more than any animal?
Just because I was so excited about them as a young man. I loved hunting elephants. I loved being with elephants. I loved studying elephants. And very early in my career, I decided to specialize on elephants because I loved them so much.
You were part of a game department that used to do a lot of culling of elephants.
Yeah.
Large numbers.
Yeah. And that started from my research that was faulty. I was wrong.
You were wrong?
Yeah, because I was taught that if there's damage to trees and grass and everything, it's too many animals.
Reducing animals, however, killing over 40,000 elephants, didn't fix the problem. The grasslands continued to turn into desert.
Well, reducing the animal numbers, it got worse. It didn't get better.
This led Alan to a radical idea, the opposite of what everyone, myself included, believes.
Now what I'm saying today is the solution is more animals, properly managed.
Alan bases his theory on the historical fact that once much, much larger herds dominated these plains. And they did so without overgrazing. But how? Alan believes it has to do with how these animals used to move. Harassed by much larger numbers of predators, including humans, the herds kept bunched together, trampling the ground like a giant plow. Alan decided to test his theory on his own ranch. First, he gathered all the cows he could find. But then, instead of just letting them roam free, he herded them into a tight bunch and kept them constantly on the move. He never let them stay in one pasture for more than 1 week.
If you put cows on it, what are they going to do to the land?
We get lots of trampling, breaking the crust of the soil, lots of dung and urine. And any gardener would understand that, because then plants will grow. If you've got bare ground and it's hard, you break the surface with a trowel or whatever, and you put mulch and litter on it, and plants grow. And it's no different on the scale.
I see what you're saying. So when you have the solid, hard, almost concrete-like ground, you put those cows in for a week in large numbers to break it up. I get this now.
To me, Alan's results are spectacular. Despite recent drought, he has transformed this ranch from desert to rich grassland. Today, the grass holds the water, and streams that were dry for decades are flowing again. Amazingly, Alan already has more cows than most scientists would recommend, and he wants to add even more cows and more wildlife.
Right now, we are trying to double the animal numbers because we don't have enough animals to keep this grassland healthy.
So you want to put 1,000 cows on this?
Absolutely.
And if you did that, and you did that for a few years, and I came back here, would I be able to notice the difference?
Yes, the land will be even healthier.
And more wildlife too?
Yes.
It's so counterintuitive. I just kind of want to shake. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, it really is.
Yeah.
Until now, many scientists like myself believed that if animals were overgrazing, then the solution is pretty obvious. Reduce their numbers. But Alan says what we really need in these habitats, in these natural areas that we think are being destroyed by elephants and other animals, elephants. We need more elephants, not less. We need more wildlife, not less. And far more than you can possibly imagine. Cows are wildlife. It actually may not matter that much. They just have to behave as if they've been herded by a dangerous predator. If Alan is right, then we may have to completely rethink life on the plains. The message is an extraordinarily powerful one, and it could be the best thing, the absolute best thing conservation has ever discovered. Alan's ideas have already inspired people all over the world. Increasingly, they are asking one question. Can you truly have large numbers of animals, thriving grasslands, and people all in the same place?